Fabian, this is your testimonial year.
Yeah, sure.
What's going on this year?
Well, a testimonial year means that I can organise all different sort of events in my testimonial. I've already organised a fashion show. It was last October. In the end of February, I'm going to organise a private party. And I'm also going to organise a golf day, which is quite common, you know, for the testimonial. And a testimonial dinner and a testimonial match. So all different sort of events throughout the whole year.
The word is often bounded about, the word legend, but you have a huge reputation, a lot of affection at Ipswich.
Yeah.
What do you put that down to?
I think pure honesty, I would say. I mean, every game when I went out, you know, you always give you 100%. And, I mean, people kind of appreciated that. I mean, obviously, I've been a loyal servant. I've been there for 10 years. And that's also the reason why the club won't be a testimonial. But, yeah, I mean, nowadays you hardly see any loyalty to a club either. I mean, players just move on for bigger, better things, you know, after 2 or 3 years or whatever. But, no, I always stay loyal to the club. And, you know, I always had a very good time over there, you know, at the club. And it treated me well. And I responded, you know, doing my best, you know, for the team for the last 10 years. And I must say, I've truly enjoyed my time up there.
And what are your plans when you eventually retire?
Well, I'm trying to go into coaching. This is one thing, and also I might set up something for myself and Fabian Wilnis Foundation, meaning that I want to try to organize kind of youth tournaments, you know, at Ipswich. And for the 30s, on the 40s, on the 50s, on the 16th, it doesn't really matter what age group. But I want to organize, tournaments, you know, that teams from all over the world are coming over to Ipswich, like, you know, from Germany, Belgium, Holland, Spain, but also South America, Canada, and even from Asia as well. So, you know, this is like, you know, the Milk Cup in Ireland? Something similar, yeah. And we haven't got it at Ipswich now. And I just want to put Ipswich Town on the map. The reason why I came up with this idea, first of all, you know, it would attract a lot of positive, you know, into the town. But also, if I go back to Holland, if I talk about Ipswich, you know, in general, people always think about the murders, you know, two, 3 years ago. And I just want to put a kind of a positive spin, you know, on the town and on the place. So that's why I came up with this idea, just to hopefully. You know, get this foundation started, so that they can organise, you know, this tournament each year.
You mentioned what people might think of in Holland of Ipswich, but mm-hmm. I like to think you might, because you're from Holland. I think of not only yourself but Arnold Muren,
yeah,
and a deep vein of class footballers.
Yeah.
When you were growing up, who were your heroes?
When I was growing up, I must say Johan Cruyff. He was a very skillful player. No, you probably know him. And Ruud Gullit. Because he used to play for my team, my local team, as Feyenoord. I was a big supporter of Feyenoord. And I used to live, let's say, 500 yards away from the football ground. And my dad was a steward up there. So every home match, I used to go with my dad, you know, to the stadium 3 hours before kickoff. It was very early, but it didn't matter. I just wanted to see my heroes up there. And you know, waiting till 2:30, that is kickoff time, you know, in Holland. And to see them play, so it was a wonderful experience. But something I really cherish. And yeah, they were my heroes up there at the time.
And what do you think? What coaching techniques can people in England learn from Holland?
I mean, in Holland we used to I think they like to keep the ball on the floor. They're quite skillful as well. And these sort of things, you know, just to pass and move and. Have a picture before you get the ball or receive the ball. Also have a picture, you know, where you're gonna play to. These sort of little things, you know, little details, which can make a player hopefully better.
And what young men of the age, say 15 to 17, thinking about a career in football, but they think that they've got a recession in front of them, which this may last for a number of years.
Yeah.
What's your advice to them?
I mean. A recession doesn't really matter, I think, because if you have a love for the game, you have a love for the game. So you mustn't become a footballer only because of the money. You must become a footballer because of the love of the game. You know, do you really love playing football, day in day out, when it's raining, when it's snowing, when it's windy, you still want to be out there and kick a ball, and that's the main thing, you know. And then hopefully, a scout or another team will pick up on you and then give you a chance or a trial or you know, gives me more chances to play for the football club. But yeah, the way I see it, from my personal point of view, and also even now at this age, I still have a love for the game. That's why I'm still playing now, because otherwise I would have probably retired like years and years ago. But no.
Brilliant. Brilliant. Thank you very much.